McLaren are absolutely dreadful at the minute. If anything, they are the worst team on the grid. Both cars with reliability issues, both cars not exactly quick. Piastri's debut lasted literally not even a quarter of the race. Where do you start with them, Logan? If you know, if Mercedes think they're in a bad position, McLaren are like, you know, this is like almost Honda level, you know, of 2015.
Yeah, I mean, I've been saying it for years. Every year, just because they have a fan base and people think the orange car looks cool, every year they are the most overrated team going into the season. I mean, it doesn't fail every year. If we could go back and look at how people think teams are going to finish, every year it's McLaren's the most overrated team. I mean, they've at least looked decent in the last few years, but hey, here we are again with another stinker of a car. I mean, you could see when it was revealed, they weren't excited about it. It just seemed like a slightly better iteration of last year's car. But whatever changes they made has also come with some mechanical gremlins as well. So, and they're also kind of unlucky in that usually at the beginning of the season, you have multiple teams with these kinds of issues. I mean, Ferrari had an engine failure, but that's just kind of par for the course at this point. But they also had another car running in the top five. McLaren's got the worst of both worlds, where both of their cars are having different mechanical issues, and they weren't looking like they were scoring points to begin with. So yeah, they're going to have to make a lot of both reliability and pace improvements. They want to be able to compete this year, and especially such a competitive midfield. When you got teams like Red Bull is going to have two cars in the points, Ferrari can have two cars in the points, Mercedes can have two cars in the points, Aston Martin has two cars in the points. I mean, unless if something bad happens to one of those teams, you're looking at only having two points positions to fight for between the other, what, six teams. So yeah, it's going to be really competitive in the midfields. This is not a great time to have these issues.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think I am at the point with McLaren where it's like, you know, serious questions have got to be asked to people like Zak Brown. You know, I know Andreas Seidel's left and I actually really rated him. I thought he was a really good team principal. And it seems like it's just gone unbelievably downhill. And I can't blame Andrea Stella for that because he's literally only just got the job. But someone like Zak Brown, you kind of like look at McLaren and I just wonder, like, what have they actually, you know, this is a team that, you know, in the 90s, you know, early, well, late kind of 2000s, you know, were winning championships and they're one of the most successful teams ever. And it's different from something like Williams, where Williams have, you know, financially just, that is why they've just fallen off. But someone like McLaren have no excuse for being that far down the order. And I feel like, nobody really thinks, you know, oh, someone like Zak Brown is at fault for it, but you know, because he's a nice guy or something, I don't know. But like, I think, you know, any other kind of team, you're looking at that top position and you're like, you know, what's going on here, guys? You know, we've gone from, what was it, 2021? You know, Ricciardo won a race and then they ended up like behind, you know. Really, they were behind Alpine last year, I'd say. And then, like, now they're like literally to the back of the grid. It's like I can't actually believe how big of a slump they've had when actually not a lot's changed in terms of regs. But yeah, super annoying because I want McLaren to do well as a Brit and you know, I like Lando, but I think you know, there's serious questions that have got to be asked because they almost like accept it, Logan. That's what I find is the worst thing. You know, if this was Ron Dennis still there. There's absolutely no way in a million years they're accepting the current level. But the, you know, Zak Brown, Andrea Stella, they're all accepting just where they are. And it's like, it seems absolutely crazy to me. What do you make about Norris? He's the other driver that has been talked about, you know, what's going to happen with him? You know, should he try and find a move somewhere else, break that contract, move to a Red Bull maybe? Where do you think? You know, what do you, if you were Lando Norris, Logan, what would you be doing right now?
I mean, I was shocked when he basically said, you know, I'm here to stay at McLaren. I was like, why? It's like, it's the mid, that team's mid, and they
Doesn't make
have been
sense.
mid for a long time. If I was him a long time ago, I never would have said, you know, I'm locked down at McLaren. I would always have kept my options open. I mean, hell, if he wouldn't have locked himself down, maybe he could have made the jump to Mercedes before Russell did. You don't know these kind of things. Maybe he could have been the look for Red Bull. It's so many what ifs, but I don't see why he would lock himself down, especially when he's always been rated so high by the community. I mean, and by the paddock.
Yeah, I think that's the thing. And yes, it's super annoying when I see McLaren basically where they were, but even worse at Bahrain last year. So I kind of hope they can improve things. But equally, if they don't change anything, they've got a very good lineup in Norris and Piastri. That's just going to get completely wasted.